प्रोफेसर इन द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ सिविल इंजीनियरिंग एट डॉक्टर बाबा साहेब अम्बेडकर टेक्नोलॉजिकल यूनिवर्सिटी लोनेरे। दिस इज माई थर्ड प्रेजेंटेशन ऑन परवियस कॉन्क्रीट। इन दिस प्रेजेंटेशन आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द कार्बन फुटप्रिंट ऑफ परवियस कॉन्क्रीट। द अर्लियर टू वीडियोज आई हैव अपलोडेड एंड दीज आर द डिटेल्स ऑफ इट। The outcome of this presentation is a learner will be in a position to differentiate between normal concrete and pervious concrete. He can understand what are the applications of pervious concrete and will be able to calculate the carbon footprint of pervious concrete. These are the list of codes and standards used for week 1 video. These are the codes and standard for week 2 video. So again, a pervious concrete, which is a low carbon footprint concrete. First we'll discuss what is carbon footprint. A carbon footprint is historically defined as the total greenhouse gas emissions caused by an individual, event, organization or product expressed as carbon dioxide equivalent. Options to reduce the carbon footprint of humans include: reduce the use, reuse the products, recycle it, and refuse. Cement is the source of about 8% of world's carbon dioxide emissions. Optimum use of cement will help in reducing carbon dioxide emissions. So pervious concrete, as per American Concrete Institute, it is defined as it's a near zero slump open graded material consisting of OPC, coarse aggregate, little or no fine aggregate, that is natural sand or crushed sand, admixtures and water. Pervious concrete is a special high permeable concrete used for flat work applications that allow water from precipitation and other sources to permeate through it, thereby reducing the runoff from a land and recharging groundwater levels. It is estimated that use of concrete itself contributes 20 to 30% total carbon emissions. It is highly acknowledged that carbon footprint of concrete must be kept within limit to ensure sustainability. Production of concrete emits a large amount of CO2 from the material production stage, such as in the production of cement, aggregates and admixtures, to the manufacturing stage, and it is expected that a reduction of carbon dioxide emission will be required for substantial sustainable development. In order to prepare a low carbon emission pervious concrete, the raw materials used should be PPC, that is Portland pozzolana cement. So in a cement, if pozzolanas are there, so we are going to reduce the use of cement in the preparation of concrete. So pozzolanas will help in getting good properties of concrete. Then coarse aggregate, fly ash, to replace the cement content directly, and water. Concrete is a major construction material used throughout the world. Pervious concrete requires less cement, no sand, hence its carbon footprint itself is very low compared to ordinary concrete. Further, its carbon footprint can be reduced by designing pervious concrete in which cement is partially replaced by fly ash, whereas the fly ash has a zero carbon emission. Basically, it's a waste product of a thermal power plant. So we'll see now what are the carbon dioxide emissions while producing a concrete. So in general, 927 kg of carbon dioxide is emitted during production of 1 ton of cement. This value, that 927, is at the place of manufacturing, and an additional carbon dioxide will be emitted during transportation, handling, placing, etc. during construction process. The process of mining of sand and gravel, crushing the stone, combining the material in concrete plant, and transporting concrete to the construction site requires very little energy, and therefore it only emits a relatively small amount of carbon dioxide, and stone or gravel and other ingredients make up to 90% of the concrete mixture by weight. It is important here to note that structures are built with concrete and not only with cement. The other ingredients of concrete also emits carbon dioxide. In general, 1 ton of coarse aggregate produces around 50 kilogram of carbon dioxide, and 1 ton of sand as fine aggregate emits around 15 kg of carbon dioxide. If crushed sand is used instead of the natural sand, the carbon dioxide emissions will be much more than that of a natural sand. Here we can see the sample calculations for carbon footprint of pervious concrete. For this sample calculation, the cement is taken as 300 kg per cubic meter of concrete, which is kept constant for the entire calculations. The first column, it represents type of concrete. So first concrete is plain concrete. The second one, that is pervious concrete, where percentage of voids is taken as 25%. And which is again kept as constant for the sample calculations to calculate the carbon footprint of pervious concrete. The second column, it shows the replacement of cement with fly ash. So for plain concrete, fly ash is 0%, but for pervious concrete, 6 different combinations they are taken, which ranges from 0% to 25%. The carbon emission of this concrete per kg cubic meter of concrete is, for plain concrete it is 367.92, whereas for pervious concrete it is less than that is required for plain concrete. So for 0% replacement of cement, the carbon dioxide emission is 344.37, whereas for 25% replacement it is 277.30 kilogram per cubic meter of concrete. So this column shows the reduction in carbon dioxide emission in kg per cubic meter of concrete. So for 0% of pervious concrete is 23.55, whereas for 25% replacement of cement with fly ash, it is 90.62 kilogram per cubic meter of concrete. That is what the reduction in carbon dioxide emission. The last column represents the percentage reduction in carbon dioxide. So we can see here that from a range of 6.40 to around 24.63, that is the reduction in carbon dioxide emission per cubic meter of concrete. So a large quantity of concrete is used throughout the world. So if we replace cement with fly ash, which is a sustainable material, we can reduce down a very huge amount of carbon dioxide emission in environment. So this shows that the carbon footprint of pervious concrete is very less compared to that of plain concrete. This is last slide in which conclusions are mentioned here. Keeping in view the above facts while designing a pervious concrete mix, concrete should be partially replaced with fly ash to get reduction in carbon footprint of the designed pervious concrete with respect to conventional pervious concrete. Pervious concrete with 100% cement has 6.4% less carbon emission compared to ordinary normal concrete. The carbon emissions for various samples of pervious concrete by replacing cement with fly ash has shown that the carbon emission in the preparation of concrete is very, very less compared to that of a ordinary concrete. Pervious concrete having 25% cement replacement with fly ash shows 24.63% reduction in carbon emission. Thus, it's clear that increased cement replacement with fly ash had reduced the carbon emissions. Pervious concrete is more environment sustainable compared to ordinary plain concrete. It's possible to reduce the carbon emission up to 25% in comparison to the conventional concrete. From this, it can be concluded that the partial replacement of cement by fly ash in pervious concrete. So from this, it can be concluded that the partial replacement of cement by fly ash in pervious concrete would certainly help in reducing carbon footprint of concrete, which minimizes the depletion of natural resources. And these are the references used for this presentation. Thank you. Thank you very much for viewing my presentation. Thanks.